crazy, but watch. Keep doing it. I mean, you guys are going to get what you guys want. And then the bad part about it, you're going to point the finger at that nigga you was taught that you wanted, that you doubted. And be like, see, I told you so. No, you set us up. You wanted this to happen. So you made it happen, okay? It ain't my fucking fault. It ain't that person's fault. You guys set it up to make it happen. You know what I'm saying? Now, you could argue, you could disagree, but just look at other people, for instance, and then try to judge what I'm trying to say, okay? Like I said, I only speak on my experience. I've been privileged to be around lots of tons of people that I still happen to know to this day, you know, and those people know who I am. Those people know what I done did. Those people do not doubt me. I do not doubt them. You know what I'm saying? To each its own. We have other problems in this fucking world than to fucking worry about, is that person good or not? Is that person that person does this and that? Do you really have that much time on your hands to really figure out what's wrong with that person? Because I could guarantee you could sit there and you could find probably a lot of shit wrong with that person if you have the fucking time to sit there and think about that person. You could write a shitload of things down what's wrong with that person. But if you really have that much time to be a hater, boom, is it cool to be a hater? You get points for that shit? Brownie point or something like that? Damn, maybe I missed that part in school, man. But you guys got this game all fucking twisted. Then you guys wonder why this world is the way this world is right now. People are scared to even talk to people. People don't even fucking go outside and have a good time hardly anymore. They just go to work, come straight home. Kids ain't really even kids no more. Why? Because us as human beings, us as adults, us as they're supposed to be leaders, are fucking selfish. We're childish. We're really ignorant. We're thinking about ourselves a little bit too much. When I was growing up, people took time out of their life to help out people, to give advice, to reach out a hand to them, to see if they could help somebody. They didn't give a fuck how many people that they influenced. They didn't care. They just wanted that one person that would come up and talk to them and acknowledge what they're doing. Making an effort. Guys, you could talk all the shit you guys want, but there's people out there making effort. There's people out there trying to do something that you little assholes cannot and will never ever fucking do. See, there's a big difference between a real one and a fake one. A fake one's going to talk shit, put you down, always think negative, shake your hand and act like you put on a fake ass fucking smile. That's a fake one for damn sure. Alright, the real one wipes it off the shoulder. The real one gets up every day. The real one takes a comment and doesn't fucking comment back, even though it should have been a fucking disrespect little thing. You gotta wipe that shit off. Why? Because there's bigger and better things to do than worry about what the fuck somebody is doing wrong. Okay? If the person's hurting, help out that person. If you see that person going down a bad road, reach out your hand and help that person. Why wait for that person to fuck up if you see something that person doesn't see? It doesn't make you any better, guys. It doesn't make you any better. You just sit in your house by yourself with your pride and be like, oh, yeah, see, I told you so. But long story short, you're the asshole who helped that motherfucker get there, okay? You might as well put the gun to the nigga's head and shot the nigga, all right? Come on, y'all, you guys are all so washed up and think what you know is right and, oh, this and that. Then why are you alone? Why ain't everybody else saying this about that person that you're acknowledging? Because you're mind-fucking yourself, guys. All right? Got to quit that shit, man. We got too much in this fucking world. We came too fucking far in this world to go back. And if you're going to let one person, even if it's a president, a cop, or whatever, fucking make that decision on taking you back, ask yourself, is it worth it? You really want to go back for this one person? We make shit happen. We are Earth. Okay, without us, there wouldn't be Earth. Without Earth, there wouldn't, you know, vice versa. But you got teamwork, when you got people, when you got things that actually shouldn't work together, but they do work together, you have wonderful things that happen after that. Wonderful things. Wonderful things. Why? Because you're taking two odd subjects or matters of life and putting them together. It's not going to work out right away. We know that. But as soon as you get the fucking map down, as soon as you fit the puzzles to the pieces of the puzzle, imagine the fucking creation that you're going to make. We need more leaders out there. We need more people, OGs out there. I know a lot of the streets are a lot better than the way they used to be. But OGs, we need to guide these little kids, the little youngsters out there, into a little right way. You know what I'm saying? God forbid, I wouldn't know what the fuck I'd be if I didn't listen to my OG. You know? But all I can say is fucking speaking of what I see, what I see, what I hear on these newses. You know, I don't really even like to speak, and I never say nobody's name. I'm not talking about in particularly anybody specifically, okay? So if you feel like I'm directing these comments towards you, or if you feel that my statements are coming right to you, no, you have some kind of guilt inside of you that you relate to what I'm saying. Because I never say nobody's name. I never talk on nobody because, like I told you guys before, it ain't my job to do that shit. But I can't sit down and let you guys try to, think what you guys are doing is right. If you guys think it's right, then why ain't everybody else doing what you're doing? Ask yourself.
What's up, man? This is your boy, Eric Loco. You're tuned in to Roll With Us Radio. Get ready for 3 hours of nonstop music. Well, I can't say nonstop because you get my ass with a little bit of mix, man. You're going to hear all types of variety of music. The best part about it, we support our underground. We support our local artists, man. Without you, there ain't no us, man. Make sure you tone up, turn it up, roll it up. Let's get this motherfucking show on the road. Let's go.
It's got a funky beat, and I can bug out to it.
Yeah. front door. The front door's a long way from the driveway. My place far by the hour out, but the 458's like catching a flight, babe. Coco White, you love my smile, babe. Wanna rock the boy, it be your Kanye. Made her feel so good, she thought I was Kanye. But I'm T-Raw, and my room's on the beach, my.
I can hear a tree. I be going real deep in my room. Let that ass get sleep. Push your head to your feet in my room. Already scared, he's a freak. But don't be using no teeth. In my room. Got some ways I can teach you. Girl, I'm a dog with no leash. In my room.
I see you, yeah. I see you, yeah.
If you ready, let's go. If you ready, let's go. I want you.
Are you okay?